Hello there, and welcome to this week's quick tip video. This week, we're looking closely at VariAudio, the pitch correction tool included inside of Cubase. Of course, there's much debate about how much pitch correction we should be using. I'm probably on the minimal side, but if you look at electronic music, then people use a lot of it quite successfully as an effect. In this case, I've got a vocal that needs some pitch correction, so I'm double-clicking on the audio file. Now I've got my sample edit window open, I can go over to the tabs on the left-hand side and go down past Audio Warp to VariAudio. Now if I click on the Pitch and Warp button, Cubase will start analysing the data inside of this track and very quickly give me a visual representation of the pitch. We've got blocks that coincide with the piano scroll on the left-hand side and squiggles that represent micro pitch. We can click on a block and then use the cursor keys on the keyboard to very quickly move backwards and forwards. You can also use the up and down cursor keys. Hold down Command and scroll will automatically snap that block into alignment with the notes on the grid. Hold down Shift and you can freely move the block up and down. That way, you can probably use your ears a little more than your eyes. You can edit multiple events at once using VariAudio by selecting all or drawing a rectangle around the events you wish to edit. Then you can go over to quantize pitch and use the slider to control just how much they are going to snap into that grid. And now you can see with it all the way up, it snapped perfectly into the piano scroll on the left-hand side. Already that's sounding better, but let's go to the straightened pitch and move that all the way up and have a listen. Sound familiar? Well, it's up to you how much you want to use, so let's drop it back to half. Already it's sounding a bit more natural, and it's definitely sounding more in tune than it did before we started with VariAudio. Now, if you've got an eye for detail, or if your job depends on it, then I would suggest going in and really checking each individual note, and we're going to cover that. Just before I do, there's one other really neat feature. You can control the pitch using an external keyboard. Just select the note, go up to MIDI input and activate it, and now play away on a MIDI keyboard. This is a massive time saver because I can combine this with the computer cursor keys and just move through the track and make sure the MIDI note is correct using my external MIDI controller. VariAudio isn't just about pitch. We can also control the entry point and the length of a note. Watch this. We're dragging the start back. I'm undoing it, and now I'm shortening the note. It's worth mentioning that VariAudio will analyze any background noise that you have in your recording and any sibilance or microphone noise. And you can see this artifact here at the start of this block. There's a little X in the middle of that block, which I'm clicking on to disable the pitch information. When I do, the block goes gray. Back over on the left-hand side in the VariAudio tab, I'm switching over to segments. There's a shortcut for this, by the way, and it's the Tab key on your computer keyboard. In segments, we can change the start and the finish point for each pitch event. So if we think it's capturing too much data at the start, we can simply drag it back. Or if it's not capturing enough at the end, we can again move it back. Have a look at this highlighted event. The pitch is fairly constant, and then the singer develops vibrato towards the end. So we can chop this by holding down with the mouse towards the bottom of the event. Now we've split it into two, and we can click on the second segment, and once again go back to straighten pitch to smooth that vibrato out a bit. Maybe it's a bit too long. No problem, we go back to pitch and warp and then just pick up on the end and shorten it. Now that it's shorter, the vibrato stands out more, so let's straighten it to get more of a natural sound. I'm hitting undo to go back to what I had before. Now the good thing about the micro pitch is I can see the vibrato, and if I want to change this little segment at the end, in the pitch and warp tab, I'm going up to the top of the event until I get the cursor. Then when I find the spot, I press down with my mouse and Cubase will remember that point. Now as I drag the pitch up and down, it will only affect the pitch from that point onwards. We can do the same at the start of events. We can also edit the micro pitch on things like curves or slides into notes. So I've picked up on the top left-hand corner of this event and I'm dragging that curve up and down. Picking up on the micro pitch in the top left and right corner of each event will affect the micro pitch of the whole event. So if you don't want to use the scissors to chop up each event, insert that marker to get greater control over the micro pitch. In addition to using scissors to chop up events inside the segment section of VariAudio, we can also glue multiple events together. To do that, draw a rectangle around the events that you wish to glue together, and then hold down the Alt or Option key on your computer keypad, and immediately they'll all lock together in the one event. Let's do a quick comparison. Without, with. Notice it's a lot more natural sitting in the track. Let's have another listen. Without and with. That pitch is way better. And before the haters start hating, look, I know it's pitch correction. But at the moment, there's not a whole lot of effects or dynamic processing over the top. And once you start adding those, the whole pitch correction takes a back seat and the vocals start pushing through a lot more. It's up to you to decide on how much VariAudio you want to use, but I promise you, once you get used to it, even if you're using it two or three times minutely on a track, it is a time saver and a lifesaver. In the next quick tip video, we're going to look at using VariAudio on multiple harmony tracks that have been recorded. I'll catch you then.